Captain's log. Stardate 57436.2. The Cerritos is docked at Douglas Station for routine maintenance and resupply. We will soon set course for the capital planet on the Galar system, where we're scheduled to make second contact with the Galardonian High Council. First contact is a delicate, high-stakes operation of diplomacy. One must be ready for anything when humanity is interacting with an alien race for the first time.
But we don't do that. Our specialty is second contact. Still pretty important. We get all the paperwork signed, make sure we're spelling the name of the planet right, get to know all the good places to eat.
Oh my god, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Oh no. Are you pretending to do a captain's log?
We're all supposed to keep logs.
Okay, let me listen to it.
No, go away.
I can't believe you're wasting your shore leave on this.
Privacy, please.
Okay, time to go. Come on, get out of the closet. Let's go. Come on.
Are you drunk?
Yeah, dude, you should be too. I mean, this station is amazing. And they have Romulan whiskey. And I bet you thought it was going to be green, but it is actually blue. It's this very beautiful color.
Romulan whiskey is against regulation.
Yeah, because it's awesome. Oh, man, they got all sorts of great stuff. Oh, come on, check this out.
Be careful with that.
Pretty sweet, right?
Yeah, it's a Klingon bat. I don't know. I'm not a scientist. It doesn't matter. Shut up. I got it from an old guy with an eye patch. Hey. Come spar with me.
Stop.
Come on. Oh, we could be Klingons. We could have crimped hair and wrinkled foreheads.
War.
I love honor. Hey, I demand honor.
After we dump this in storage, let's hit the bar and see if we can get a cute lieutenant to argue with me.
Interesting. Why would you want that?
I don't know. Getting some uptight hunk all wound up just gets me off.
Supplicate yourselves!
Ah! What the heck?
Whoa, it's one of those transdimensional energy creatures!
Behold! And tremble at me!
Quick, Tendi, grab one of those canisters!
Shouldn't we call security?
I will destroy you!
No, we can use this thing for all sorts of cool stuff. Hey, grab the pod! We can figure it out later!
He's a sentient creature. Are we even allowed to stuff him in something?
Oh, he's a bad guy! He zaps people!
I shall make a feast of your misery! No, wait, don't put me in the pod! I can grant you wishes!
And I'm listening.
I can rearrange air molecules into whatever you want!
Even one of those fancy new tricorders with the purple stripe.
Ooh, those are nice!
Oh, that would use up a lot of my... Okay, just I'll try. There you go.
Where's the power cell, dude?
What, really?
Like I was gonna ask for something that didn't come with batteries.
Okay.
Thank you.
I really gotta think of something cool to say when we're going to warp.
Die, Porto!
Something like, it's warp time. What do you think of that? Is that good for you?
That was titled Essence. I wrote it about my mom. This next piece is also about my mom. Excuse me.
Wrap it up, nerd. Right, I don't know what this is called, and I don't care. 2, 3, 4.
What is the meaning of this intense bass? Are you mocking me?
I don't hear it on our side. It must be your equipment.
Engineer Kanach, today you die!
Will someone shut that up?
You're welcome.
Okay, whatever that was. Ladies and gentlemen, Requiem for a Hug.
Captain says you're too loud!
Oh god, oh no, I'm so sorry!
Stardate 57538.9. The Cerritos is working alongside the USS Merced in the relocation of an ancient generation ship, which due to some unknown calamity, never reached its destination. Her crew, adrift for centuries, mummified in disabled cryo units. Their most precious cargo, mysterious containers of molecular fluid which generates life from inorganic material. We suspect they plan to use it on a dead planet to create a habitable environment they could call home. The Merced is here to ensure the generation ship is preserved during transportation, and I want everyone to give them full support. Captain Durango and I both served on the Illinois many years ago, and it is a true delight to be able to work with him again. Trouble sleeping, Ensign?
Nah, I slept great. I mean, maybe too good, honestly.
Just distribute the pads.
Starfleet believes this alien vessel is equipped with unique terraforming technology, an elemental fluid which can transform inert matter into a living ecosystem. Towing it will be a delicate procedure. Even the slightest flux in tractor beam stabilization could damage...
I'm so sorry. It is just so much information. I don't know how you guys aren't yawning.
Your crew doesn't appear to appreciate the gravity of our undertaking, Captain.
I assure you, Captain, my people are the best in the fleet. They're proficient, alert, and... Mariner!
I am trying to hold it in!
What are you doing?
Sometimes I hum warp engine sounds just to, you know, soothe myself.
Well, that is not what the engine sounds like.
That was Enterprise D at warp 4. This is Cerritos.
Oh, yeah. I get it. It's like...
Fletcher, no. The Cerritos has inverted plasma distributors, so it's a little bit higher pitch, like...
Wrong. The shh doesn't come from the distributors. It's the vibrations in the dilithium disbursement manifold. It's like this.
No, guys, it's like this.
Dude, I'm telling you, it's...
And Voyager was all...
Are we doing the engine sound?
Security to Deck 11. Something is very wrong down here.
On the ground! Now!
We're just having the
shit freeze!
Oh, it is a little higher.
Who knew repairing the station grid would involve so much sprinting?
No talk, sleep.
I did it! I updated the dog.
What does that even mean?
In medical, they encourage us to do side projects. So I took a bunch of inner carbon and built myself a fluffy friend from scratch. It's supposed to look like a dog, you know, from Earth.
Tendi, please get it out of here.
Oh, of course. Come here. She's 5% faster and 6% smarter. You know, I hand-edited all 6 billion sequences. It was really fun.
When did you even find time for that?
Sometimes when I say that I'm going to the bathroom, I'm really recoding her DNA. This little lady's protein bonds totally accepted the Cas9 snipping without any cellular degradation. Who has malleable protein bonds? You do. Yes, you do.
I don't get it. You could have built any life form at all and you did this? It just looks like a normal dog.
That's exactly what I was going for! I'll go grab my notes so I can read you the juicy parts. You're going to love how I reorganized her mitochondria. No spoilers, but it's super funny.
Just to be clear, this is a normal dog and she's messing with us.
Oh, God, not a normal dog.
Wake me up if it turns into something I need to care about.
Oh, God. No. This is bad. This is very bad. I'm not supposed to be here. I have a pottery class at 0900.
Hey, just calm down. We don't know what this is.
Are you kidding me? Creepy stone walls, jagged metal bars. This has alien prison written all over it.
A prison? Nah, no way, man. This is a dungeon.
That's even worse. Hello? Could someone give us some context in here, please?
A dungeon? But we didn't do anything, did we? I've been replicating a lot of ice. Are we not supposed to do that? I really like ice.
I saw the captain and the bridge crew get taken into another room.
What if they were replicating ice too?
Guys, this is basically a resort compared to what the Klingons do to you. I'm sure it's not a big deal.
Oh, God. Oh, no.
They're not oppressed. We raise them as food. They like it.
Well, we are delicious.
No, you should be free to do whatever you want. What do lizards like to do?
Bask.
Okay, then you should bask without fear of being eaten.
Well, that does sound nice.
This will not stand!
Buddy, my captain's on the way right now. It's funny, normally I'm like a huge disappointment to her, but this time she's gonna be pumped that I rooted out injustice. And here comes the praise in five...
Attention, everyone! I'm afraid my ensign has made a huge mistake.
What?
Starfleet is forbidden from interfering in your planetary politics. You will be free to determine your future without our influence.
What? How could you... Don't screw the Prime Directive!
Hey, You are way out of bounds here.
They're eating those guys. What am I supposed to do?
Report it to me. Now I have to explain why there's an interspecies war on a planet that was peaceful yesterday.
Oh, so you're yelling at me for spreading freedom because you don't feel like filing a report?
Mariner, I swear if you weren't my daughter, you'd be off the Cerritos.
If I wasn't your daughter, you wouldn't be such a bitch all the time.
That's it. That's it. When we get back to the ship, you are going straight to...
Yeah, I know. Straight to the brig. Shocker.
Oh, you're not going to the brig. You're going to therapy.
What? You think I need therapy? What? That's... No! No, it's the 80s, dude. We don't have psychiatric problems.
You're a loose cannon. I don't care how many lizards you save. You need professional help.
Dr. Miglimo? Oh, he's the worst counselor in the fleet. He just tosses out nonstop food metaphors.
That's an order, Ensign. Freeman to Cerritos. One to BMO.
I don't need therapy!
Okay, look, will you stop eating these guys if we give you food replicators?
I don't know. Can they make nutrient pellets?
Yes!
The Cerritos is in orbit around Beta 3. Back in the day, these guys worshipped a violent god called Landru, who suppressed their creativity and made them kill each other until Kirk figured out it was actually a computer. Get this. At some point, these knuckleheads went back to worshipping Landru. Captain Freeman has been setting them straight all morning.
I can't believe you all started re-worshipping the dang computer.
Well, Landru's very persuasive.
Consume the intruders! Obey Landru!
Hey, don't make me paradox you into destroying yourself.
Landru apologizes!
Oh, this is literally the exact thing Captain Kirk taught you. Maybe write it down this time. Cerritos, two to beam up.
Well, I like purging people during the red hour. I'm going to keep doing it.
Dude, there is no more red hour, okay? Let it go.
But I just bought a new scythe.
Landru.
Yeah, I know. It's always weird revisiting planets from the TOS era.
TOS?
It's what I call the 2260s. Stands for those old scientists. You know, Spock, Scotty, those guys. Seems like they were stumbling on crazy new aliens every week back then.
Nothing against second contact missions, but the Cerritos should be popping in on those legacy civilizations before they unravel.
Yeah, but popping in is against regulation. We would need specific orders.
I just hate seeing a perfectly good society get destroyed by a gamester of Triskelion or whatever, because Starfleet has a policy of some intervention. Set coordinates for Starbase 77.
Sorry, Captain, but we still have crew on Beta 3.
I didn't authorize that. Who is it?
Art supplies! Get your art supplies! We got paints, we got brushes, we got a spiky pencil twirl around thingy. Boost your creativity. Express yourself. Stop praying to a computer!
Oh boy, incoming lecture in 5, 4...
Who wants crayons? Here you go, kid. Way better than the red hour.
Since when do you break protocol?
I'm just tired of you getting to do all the good stuff while I stick to the rules.
Whoa, look at Brad Boimler being cool for once. Wait, is this because of my teachings?
Okay, you don't teach, you just instigate chaos.
Exactly, helpful character building chaos.
I can hear you, can you hear me?
Aw, Boims, I thought you were gonna get stuck in middle management, like this pathetic little fly in amber, like Ransom.
I am not a little fly in amber!
What did it, huh? My constant mockery, my nonstop prodding, my downright dangerous hazing.
No. Look, if you have to know, I found out about your secret.
You mean never eating after 7? It's a miracle, right? I mean, it does work. You should try it.
Captain Freeman is your mom.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, come on, Mariner. The captain's your mom. Your dad's an admiral. You're basically Starfleet royalty. I mean, how cool is that?
Shut the f*** up right now, Boimler. Shut your f*** mouth.
This is a good thing. Now we can both do some good, and you'll just, you know,
keep us out of trouble with your mom.
What? No, that is not how
I just don't understand why it's such a secret. I'd be telling everyone.
Dude, I don't want people knowing my mom is my mom.
Okay. I'm not gonna tell a soul.
I'm being serious. Shut up!
So, does Captain Mommy give you a
sweet little captain kisses?
Apologies for the delay. You aren't the only Federation spy I'm interrogating today.
Ensign Beckett Mariner?
No biggie. I don't have anything else going on.
We'll see if you're so cavalier after a taste of my excruciator. Ready to talk?
Yes. It's only been a couple of months working with my mom instead of behind her back. The line between mom stuff and captain stuff has gotten real fuzzy.
Your captain is your mother?
Yeah, lady, everybody knows that. Keep up. I thought you were good at this.
I used to sneak away and do all sorts of little off-the-book side missions without cluing her in. Now, that's impossible. She's so happy. It's very sweet. But I am losing my mind. I don't know how much longer I can do this.
Guards!
Oh my god, Mariner, you gotta get me out of here. They keep showing me lights.
No, I am still mad at you.
Well, if we're going to the Titan, but you knew I wanted to get a promotion. You're supposed to be my mentor.
You snuck off in the middle of my shift without saying goodbye. You know who my best friend is now? My mom. It sucks. It's like work.
Look, I'm a hologram, okay? I'm sure real Boimler had his reasons. I don't know, maybe did you ever intimidate him?
What? No, shut up!
No, Mariner.
You're abandoning your fellow officer?
Yeah, well, he did it first. Stop him! Like, I never ask for special treatment. That is not my style. I mean, I won't turn it down, though. Oh, wait, does that make me a bad person?
You are an extremely bad person.
Wow, you are nasty. Words can hurt just as much as torture equipment, all right?
Good!
I guess I'll just have to get used to it, you know? Life is all about change. I just always thought she'd kick me out of Starfleet.
You'll never escape, right?
Oh, wait, you're talking about the detention center? Come on, I'm like practically escaped already. Read the room. Jennifer.
Ugh, what are you doing?
Cardio, plus a little strength training.
So you work out by staging Cardassian prison breaks.
Yeah, what do you do?
Yoga.
Wow, how unique.
Whatever. Captain wants you in her ready room.
Look, I know we're not supposed to have interpersonal conflict, but I really hate that Andorian. All right, here we go. Computer, resume program.
What are you? Why are you squatting? We're going to die! Stop that!
I can't. It's leg day.
I'm so zonked.
The red alerts from that wormhole kept me up half the night.
Oh, I know. It's like, are we crossing the event horizon or not? Like, I don't care, actually. I just want you to pick one. Jet, what are you doing here?
Got reassigned to beta ship. Looks like we'll be showering together.
Cool. Well, welcome to the team. I'm sort of the unofficial leader. Feel free to come to me with any questions.
She's joking, right?
Nope.
Ooh, actually, usually Boimler leaves that one open for me. He has issues with communal nudity.
Well, I'm not him, and he's not here.
Cool. Hope this isn't too high for you.
Fine with me. I could go higher.
That's a little high, don't you think?
Not for me.
This is my favorite.
I think I'm clean.
Yes.
I could do this all day.
Never felt more alive.
Welcome back to the Cerritos, Mr. Boimler. When you were gone, we tightened security protocols. If you run into any problems, just flag it for Billups.
Thank you, sir. It's good to be back. Computer, Papusa, hot.
User not recognized.
It's Ensign Boimler, come on.
User not recognized.
Can you, like, hurry it up?
Computer, any food, hot, please.
User not recognized.
Whoa. What's the rush? We don't have to report till 0800.
There's a bunch I need to do before my shift starts. Recalibrate the omnidirectional restraints, prep the hypo sprays.
Wait, is this about Ensign Escher?
Yes, I can't believe she got promoted over me. I do way more.
Escher got lucky. I mean, curing the captain's Torellian death syndrome, she was in the right place with the right hypo spray.
Nah, I can't rely on people getting syndromes. I have to show Dr. Ta'ana I've got what it takes.
What up? We doing sci-fi stuff today?
Nah, gotta go kick medical butt.
Computer. Ketchup, spicy kiwi.
seeing this?
Yeah, who messes with ketchup?
Shax is alive?
Yeah, guess so. Bridge officers are always coming back from the dead. You gonna finish that muffin?
But how? He died in an explosion saving my life.
I don't know, but whatever happened killed his taste buds for good.
I mean, I don't have all my memories, but I know for sure he saved me. They're gonna tell me how he came back, right?
Nope. Best to not think about it.
Please, just anything. I'm so hungry. Jax has the gym in 20, but we should have time for a quick round.
Ooh, you guys gonna go ambo? Can I get in on that?
Sure, more the merrier.
3 months of midnight practice is finally gonna pay off.
Can't wait to see the look on her face.
Glad you're still into this. I was worried maybe I came down too hard on you last time.
Hopefully we picked up a few of your moves.
Nothing like some friendly ambo jitsu to work up a sweat.
We've been training on the holodeck at night.
You might want to take off the kid gloves.
Oh, you okay? I didn't
mean... great. I can finally get in a real workout.
Still got 10 minutes.
Captain's log, stardate 58105.1. The Patlets continue their unprovoked attacks on Federation trade routes. Seeking a ceasefire, the Cerritos is on a diplomatic mission to the Patlet homeworld, which they call Patlet Planet. Starfleet Command entrusted me with this mission because of our experience with the Patlets last year. Negotiating a ceasefire would be a huge achievement.
If you keep doing Picard-level peace brokering like this, they might give you an Enterprise.
Well, I don't know about that. Remember, it's just the Packlids. This shouldn't be too complicated. Ambassador Grubden.
Welcome, Captain Janeway. Packled Planet is big and strong.
Right. Well, I'm actually Captain Freeman of the Cerritos. I'm here to discuss a ceasefire.
Oh, I was misinformed. I do not have a big enough helmet to make ceasefires.
Okay, well, then I need to talk to someone with a bigger helmet.
Stand back!
Guys, the prisoner Rumdar, he ran away from Packlet Planet to her ship.
You! Why did you steal Rumdar?
I can assure you we did no such thing. Ransom, is there a Packlet on my ship?
That's an affirmative, Captain.
This ship is strong. I can live here now.
We think he's requesting asylum.
No! Until she gives Rumdar back, Janeway stays here!
Hundred-year war, all because a computer tricked us into fighting each other. It's so embarrassing.
A lot of civilizations blame it on the supernatural. At least you didn't fall for that.
Yeah, that would have been crazy.
Here's your Lord Agamus, safely disconnected from his network of drones.
Hey now, this has all been a huge mistake. Just let me access your computer mainframe and I'll explain everything.
Nice try. Save it for the roboticists at the Daystrom Institute. Ransom?
All right, fella, in you go.
So, you're the muscle, huh? Bet you couldn't throw me into that control console over there.
Over there? By that network port? That's nothing. I could easily toss...
Oh, you almost got me.
I underestimated your intelligence. Clearly, you should be the captain.
Yeah. Anyone hungry?
I could eat.
I don't know why I keep giving alien street food a chance. It's always such a gamble.
Captain, we're being hailed.
On screen. Queen Palana, to what do we owe this pleasure? Again.
We're having a spot of engine trouble here on the Mona Veen. My Royal Engineers can't seem to suss up the hiccup. Carol, you're the closest Starfleet ship in the Quadrant. As such, I must call upon the aid of your Chief Engineer.
What a surprise.
Captain, we have completed the...
My dear Amberithio! Have you been eating? You're wasting away. And what happened to that mustache? It is thinning.
Hello,
are you taking your vitamins?
Mother.
You must start eating eggs.